Ay, o sea. Oh, I missed it. I missed it. I was supposed to go King A8. I just flubbed it. Forgot about Rook A6. It was so bad. To go after one game? Are you for real, Benjamin? Seriously? After one game, he's gotta go. I gotta go. I gotta go. So he's going for hit and run, hit and runs. Okay. Let's go here and here, I guess. I mean, nor well, I would say in general terms, the reason it's really not acceptable to play one especially is because normally you should play with white and black. Above and beyond anything else, that's the first thing that I would say is that it's really not appropriate to play just one game because then you don't have an even match of like white and blacks. I think I'm gonna play just here and take, or take with a bishop maybe. I don't know, bishop g5 is maybe better. I'll take and go like bishop f4. He's gonna go here. I don't really like my position actually, but it's probably okay. If I can get g4, I'm fine. I can always trade, I'll just drop back. If he goes there, I'm just gonna drop back. I'm not scared of d5. I don't know what that does exactly. Go b3. There's no trick, right? Knight e6, just bishop e3. Because now I can line up his knight, and he's now I get my correct development with queen d2, rook d1, and I should be much better now. Yeah, because now I go here, rook d1, and now this is exactly what I was hoping for, because I get the perfect setup. I go back, I can play f3 or g4. F4 actually looks pretty reasonable. F4, e5, I don't care, I just go e5, let's go back. He's probably has to go queen c7. He wants d5, but I can maybe even trade and just pop a knight on b5. g4 expansion is good too. That doesn't really concern me, I don't think. I can expand. Yeah, let's just keep expanding here. Thank you to Tal Houdini for the tier one. Thank you so much, Tal Houdini. Appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, it does go d5, so I have e5 or captures. Let's see. If I take, he takes. E5, knight e4, knight e4, knight e4. Knight e4, knight e4, takes, takes. I think I just take probably, because I can just take with a bishop. Maybe queen e1 was better, actually. I don't know. We'll see. We'll find out in a second. Man, I wish Charlie was still playing chess. Yeah, Charlie, okay, let's go here. Let's offer the trade. I thought I had like knight c6 or something. I know I'm better here. It's just a matter of the precise angling. I guess I go here, and bishop d4 maybe. I don't love it. But I think I'm better for sure. Oh, I've got knight c7. Oh, rook e8, I have knight c7. I didn't actually see that. Okay, so then I must be better. If he has to go here, then bishop e3, and now this is just very pleasant for white. It's not necessarily winning, but it's definitely not good for black. Let's go here. Just g5. Takes, 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 knight e4. He just loses the juicer, so this is just really bad. So I take, and it's game over. Okay, it goes knight d7, logical. I think I just take, and I have knight c3. And what's his reply? He can't push, so I just take. He can't guard. This should just be GG. Charlie's just been busy. Don't think he quit though. No, Charlie loves chess. I haven't really spoken to Charlie in a while, but he's a big fan of chess. He always has been. Anish's live playing Bullet. Oh wow, Anish is playing Bullet. Awesome, awesome. Good stuff. Good stuff. Okay, now I can take with the knight or the bishop. It's just a question of which one I take. With knight takes looks optically right for knight f6. I think it is right because I always have knight f6. Although he's got bishop c5. Ah, I should have taken with the bishop probably. Although, I mean, this is still probably quite. This is definitely just good. I can just retreat. Because the pawns are very weak here, and it's actually good that I've got an outside connection. That doesn't look right. Let's go here, kick the rook. Yeah, I expected that. I will just take. Takes. I can just play like king f2, king f3. Let's play h4, consolidate first. Okay, let's just go here. If rook e4, just rook d4, or even knight d6. I'm just gonna go here and hit this, and then I also have knight f4 to kick the king. Let's go here. Knight f4, big threat. I think I just do it anyway. I want to bring the rook down. That doesn't concern me. Just play h5. g6 is a problem. Okay, he goes there. This has to be winning. Wait a second. Let's just go here. If he takes, I take, take. It's just two juicers now. Oh, that was actually kind of stupid of me. I made this a bit messy for no real reason. Let's go here on king e3, maybe? Now, what am I doing? What am I doing? So, here maybe? He's gotta move the knight. I take. His king is kind of boxed here. So I take. There's no stalemate. I have to be clear on that. Actually, now I just run the other way and I just win. Yeah, let's go here, here. A5 should win. H6 also should win. Let's just go here and here. Let's go here. Win the game. Let's keep going. Let's go here. Maybe knight d5, d6. Let's take with the e-pawn. Keep it really slow. Challenge Anish. Anish is probably too rated at bullet, I'm betting. What is Anisha's bullet rating, you guys? I did not have mate in one. No, I didn't have mate in one, I don't think. He does it this way. So, I mean, I think d5 is definitely playable at some point. But I'm going to go here, bishop h5, g6, I think. Okay, I can actually play d... No, okay, let's go here. Trade some bishops. I should have played rook e8 first, but it's all good. Yeah, Anisha's 3,000 at bullet. I mean, as much as I love Anish and he's a great guy, I can't play him at 3,000. Like, that's ridiculous. I've got to go b6 and chip the structure next move, too. It goes g4. This is actually kind of a little bit sketchy. Like, very sketchy. I have rook e8, maybe. This is not a good position for me. I think I go rook e8 so that he never has f4. Now I try to reroute. Okay, he misplayed this, I think. Did he? Let's go here, knight g6, maybe. I think he misplayed this. I don't think he should have put the pawns and the bishop like this, because now he has problems on some dark squares here. I think it's still not completely clear cut. Let's just go b6 and chip. Go b4, I'll take, he'll take. Takes this way, knight e5 looks... Whoa, really? I didn't think he could do that. He does it anyway. I go knight e5. I'll pre-move this in case he takes. If he doesn't take, I go c6. I think I'm doing pretty well. I don't know, maybe this was correct, but it didn't feel right thinking about it. What? Oh, he's got knight f6 or something? Oh my god, did I really just blunder? Maybe I just did. Knight f3, king h1. What's going on? Go here. I can take and take, take, take. This is very sharp. He goes rook e3, I take. And I have c6 also. Very, very sharp position. I don't know what's going on here. I guess I'll... I think rook e5 is a safe pre-move, so I'll pre-move it. I think it's take with the knight too. Take six, knight seven, rook c8, bishop g3, rook e3 is good. Knight d5, rook a3. Yeah, like, okay, so he goes, wait, what? I just fork him and he can resign now. GG's. Let's take, let's go c6, kick the juicer, and now it all folds like a cheap suit. Just go here, trade some rooks off. I don't care that he has knight f5. Now I just jump in it. Rook a2 takes. Just take. Just go here. Now knight a5 doesn't really do much. I can just drop back, guard the juicer, bishop c7. His knight on h5 is completely dead. I mean, everything wins, but I'll just take. Let's just go here. Knight c4, just rook a1, f6, he resigns. Let's keep going. Let's go e4, maybe knight c3. And now you resign, yeah. Okay, let's play with d6. Wait a second. Knight g5 here? No, let's just go d4. I guess queen d4 maybe? Or knight d4. Let's just play knight d4, keep it simple. Drop the bishop back. Oh, I had knight f5. Why didn't I play knight f5? Whoops. Okay. Let's go here. I'm gonna go knight f5 next move. Is what frowned upon? Let's go knight f5, hit the bishop. Of course I take it. It's two bishops. Just play a3, consolidate the structure. Bishop b2, maybe f4. Very, very pleasant position for me. Do I go rook b1 or do I offer the trade? I assume there I've got more space. So the general rule of thumb is when you have more space on the board, you don't want to trade pieces. Like I've got more of the center. So the general principles are that you don't trade pieces when you have the center. So I'm going to keep the rook on the board, even though it cost me one tempo. What did Anish? Oh, did Anish say the same thing yesterday? Did Anish literally say the same thing? He did? Well, what can I say? Great minds think alike. Let's play rook d1. But yes, yeah, you guys. So that is actually a general rule, is that when you have more space, you don't trade off pieces. It's not of course universally true, but it's a pretty deep concept. It's generally that's how it goes. So does he have some bishop g4 f3 queen b6 silliness? No, because I just block. Huh, okay. This is very weird. What is my dude doing? I can take and go queen d4. I can also move the knight, which looks very attractive, but that's just a free juicer. Okay, I mean my dude is on tilt, I think. Let's just now I'm up a pawn, so now that I'm up a pawn, I don't mind trades actually. So let's go here. Even though I have more space, now I don't mind trades. Why do I not play Vicon Zay often? I left the TSM facilities. We're doing a sponsor stream today, you guys, so I kind of need to be at home because we're gonna need to do something later that I can't really do as easily at the facility. Let's put it that way. I made some cash by betting on Fedoseev versus Alireza. Thanks for the tip. Oh, no worries, dude. I mean, I knew the odds were wrong. I mean, there's no way that Fedoseev was 3-1. Like, it's literally not possible. I mean, Fedoseev was a dog for sure, but I thought Fedoseev was 2-1. That was my line. My personal line was Fedoseev was 2-1. But 3-1 is just, I mean, that's just bad. That's just bad odds making. Now I have extra pawn, extra everything. I mean, that's just the dream. Two bishops and an extra pawn. This is like the absolute dream. You can't ask for more in life than two bishops and an extra pawn. Let's go rook a7. Okay, now I just bring my king in. Oh, this is so beautiful. Let's go bishop d3, cut the f5, no knight e5s, and just slowly take the space. We're just going to take all his space, are belong to me. I can play f5, which is kind of mean. So actually, let's just go here. He can't push, he can't move. I mean, that's just so bad. I want two bishops and a pawn for Christmas. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two pawns. I can't do it, sorry. Let's go bishop d4. Let's just trade. Again, two bishops and an extra pawn. Just very clean. I think f5 is actually probably cleanly winning with king f4 and e5. Because I have a 3v2 on the king side, so this is winning. I didn't need to do this with the two bishops. Wow, g5, interesting. Let's take and go check. So I can take and go king f5, I think. And that should be winning pretty easily. Okay, I think I go here. He can't go here because then he's down two. So he needs to exchange the wrong bishop. And now my bishop gets happy, and it's just winning. Let's go here, target the juicer. I mean, he's going to try to find some way to keep this alive. But I'm actually willing to trade because now all his juicers are on light, and mine are going to be on dark. I just take and go here, and it's just GG's. I have one extra juicer. If he goes here, I just trade, and we win down the king and pawn endgame. Let's go. Let's just play e5 this time. Let's go here. Let's play a5. I can play knight a7 here. I think bishop g4 is pretty good, actually. He takes. I just drop the bishop back to like d6, I guess, or b6. I think I go to d6 in case he takes. Let's just come here. I've got knight h4, but I can just move my queen and move the knight back to e7. Am I worried about DMCA? I already spoke about DMCA a little bit before, but I mean, like, let's just go here, target the pawn. Knight h4, I'm gonna go knight h5, or maybe even just knight no, knight e4 is no good. Does that. I mean, this should be okay for me. I'm actually not playing this great, though. I'm gonna do something unusual and take with this way and go h6 and king h7, and maybe g5 at the right moment. This is a little bit sketchy, but I think it's playable. Let's go. I think I'm just gonna go here and rook f8 and really put pressure. He's probably gonna try to trade with rook a1, and I don't know if I really care. Okay, so what? Go knight h4. I don't care. I just go king h7. Big deal. He's probably, you should go king g2 or something. Okay, he does that. I'll go here to make sure I don't gambit something on this. I have knight f4 at the right moment, or even queen f6 for that matter. Queen d7 also maybe. Rook a3 also playable. Stop counting the pawns. I know. Let's just stop counting everything while we're at it, eh? I'm gonna just go here because now knight h4. I always have knight f4. I mean, he has knight h2, but I wonder if I have knight f4 there and takes and f3 and knight e5. Knight f3, knight e5, queen f3, queen e5. I think it's okay. I think it's okay. Yeah. I also have rook a3. Big threats here. Big threats. Goes b5. No, I haven't finished Queen's Gambit, unfortunately. I haven't gotten around to it. I think this is a bad move, actually. I think I go here. So I'm going to go here, and eventually I'm going to reroute the knight. I also c6, maybe? Oh, but c6 does nothing. Okay, let's just go, like, rook d8, maybe. I always have b6 or c6 or c5. Very sharp position, although I gave him this, which I shouldn't have given him. Let's go c6. I've got to be careful here. I don't, this actually isn't what I wanted to do. Let's go here. Yeah, how's it going, dude? Play rook a8. Maybe bishop c5 is a move at some point. I want to put pressure on this bishop long term, but I can't because my knight is stuck. Knight f4, knight h4, I always have knight f4. Okay. Let's just go here, try to trade now. I'm not worried. Because now there are problems with the pawn as well, I think. Both pawns are weak. He's trying to infiltrate. I can play rook d8. I also have knight f6. Yeah, he just missed knight f6 completely, just touching the rook. And now I can take. I can also just go rook e8. I should actually be doing quite well here if I play this precisely. Queen c3, he's got knight h4, but then I have knight b3. Just take. Goes. But now I cut him. Oh, I blundered rook d3. No, I didn't have knight c1. He missed it. Okay. What is this? What is this, though? I'm just. Oh, I could have taken. I could have taken on e4. I'm so bad at chess. I'm so bad. So bad at chess. Oh, wait. I know I'm still better here. Let's go queen b4, target the pawn. Wait. There's got to be something. Maybe rook e8 and g5. Let's go here. Game knight f3. Stupid. Ooh, that looks like a really bad move. Because it gives me a hop. I don't actually care, do I? Wait. And if I don't, let's go. I've got to be very careful. Let's go here. Let's go here. But now I have rook d2, maybe? Knight f3, rook b2. Check, 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 check! I think that wins. Go here. Here, 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 here. Go here. Go here. I think I'm winning. Let's go here. go here. Sorry, you guys, that was a little bit random. Sorry, that's like tick, 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 like a complete insane lunatic. Sorry about that, you guys. Let's go Qe2 and Bishop e3. That kind of sounded really bad, like I'm some kind of schizo or something. Let's go Nf3 here. That was not good. Yeah, it's okay, we're used to it. Do I have e? I'm gonna do it. I don't know if it's good, but let's go Nd4. I feel like I should have some ideas here. Nxg5 looks strong. Bg5 with Nd6, Bg5, Nd5. Ke7 maybe. Or I can go this knight to g5 maybe. What's this move? If h6, I'm 100% sacking, I assume. Because I have check and Qg4. I mean, maybe he can get away with it, but it looks very sketch. Actually, I don't know. XSCEs. I think that was a mistake. I think he could have played h6 take 6 knight g5 king jakes here. I think he believed me. He thought I was Mikhail Tal. Okay, let's just drop the bishop back, I guess. He's got knight c5, which he'll play for sure. Let's just go here maybe. I don't like this. He's got a good bishop. Let's go here. Not worried. I mean, he's gonna have to castle at some point. He's castling into my big attack. Whether it's big or not, we'll see. But he's gonna have to castle into something over here on the king side eventually. Like, I'd probably go knight h4 next move and bishop b4. Let's go here. I'm gonna go queen g4 and line it up. Doesn't have f6, loses the juicer. Qe7, Qg4. How was the gym? Oh, the gym was good. I was over at the TSM gym this morning at like 6 a.m. I think I'm doing well here. Maybe bishop b4 next move. I thought I could go queen g4. I mean, I don't know. He's really asking for it. He's asking for the big punishment, but I don't actually have the big punishment. I can play rook f3. Maybe I go, no, bishop a5, he just goes rook c8. That would be moronic. d4 is, what about rook f3 maybe? Yeah, then I'm just gonna go rook g3 and really try to hammer home the point that his king is very vulnerable here. Rook f6, gf, queen h, ooh, rook f6 was interesting, but I don't think it works, because he can also take and just check me. Yeah, it doesn't work. It's a great idea. 6 a.m. I mean, what's the saying? The early bird gets the worm, right? Or something? I don't know what the saying is. Anyway, let's go queen h5. Knight f4, I take, and he just gets sauce on h6. There's gotta... Wait, what? How is there not a win here? This looks insane. I can go rook g3. Knight f4, I just take. g3, rook g8. Wait a second. Rook h3. Rook h3, f6, no. Rook h3, gh4, no. Rook h3, queen c5, king h1, no. I think this is right. Because here I just take. If takes, I just take this. I'm threatening this, which is the reason I think rook h3 is strongest. Bishop g5, queen g5, takes, queen g7 holds all the glue for black. It looks so close to winning, but it doesn't quite work. But this, however, I'm pretty sure it's just winning. I also have knight g6 to hit the queen and the rook, and the bishop on d2 is so strong, so I think this is winning. What kind of backhand in tennis? I use a two-hand primarily, a two-hand and the slice. I use both, but I don't know what his next move is. Like, I saw queen c5, but I'm one move from checkmate. He does this, but it doesn't do anything, I don't think. I just take, and I can even just be very, like, very quiet with knight f3, and he can't guard anything, and it's ggs. Let's keep going. Okay, let's keep going. I didn't get a good position last game, so please knight d2. Okay, it's gonna be the same thing. Let's play a5. I have knight h5. I'm just gonna play h6 this time and drop back. Just take over here. Whoa. Maybe b5 next move as well. Reclaiming the 3.2k throne. I'm just playing blitz. It's fun. When my rating starts tanking, I get to actually enjoy myself and play blitz. I mean, it was like 3250 a couple days ago, but now I get to just relax and play blitz again because every game is like +3, +4, so it's fun. When games are like, when you're like 3250 and every game is like +2, it's really unpleasant. I had rook a2. I wonder about rook a2 now, actually. Then rook b2, rook a1. I mean, I want to win the game, so I think I'm gonna do something dubious here. Rook a2 is probably just completely equal, but I'm gonna do something dubious because I want to win the game. Bishop f8 was better because he's got this. Ugh. How do I make this messy? h5 looks sketchy. Let's go here and here. They still got him. Yeah. No, it's no good. Oh no, I've got bishop g5 and rook a2 maybe. Was not expecting that move. I'm gonna go here and trade, maybe, and trade like this. Do I take with the pawn or the knight? I think this is pretty gross. I think I just take with the pawn and have to go knight e7. Not very happy about this. Was not expecting that move. I have g4. I think that's a mistake, actually, because now my knight's gonna get to g5 or f6. I think there are problems for white with the pawn hampering his kingside development here. Like knight g5, knight e3. I guess I have no. Oh, I can take him. No, then queen d8. Knight e3, queen a2. Queen a2, 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 knight f1. Queen a2, rook d1, knight f3, queen a2, queen a2, queen a2, queen a2. Queen g4, rook d2, trade, queen g5. Queen a, nah, it's no good. It's close. It's close. Let's go here. I really wanted knight g5, knight e3, queen a2, but then after queen g4, oh, it would have been okay. Oh, it would have been okay. It probably was okay. Whatever. Okay, I'm gonna try to reroute this knight though. He's gonna have to move this knight. Queen a2, or yeah, let's go here, knight g5. Now he's in real trouble though, because after I go knight g5 anyway and I take and I fork the king and the queen, I get kind of the family trio. I need a reboot. Yeah, thank you to a Ductator for the tier one Vibby. Thank you to Kinesis. Thank you to Rolling Me Vikes for the 17. Thank you so much, you guys. Okay, he wants, I can go knight g5 and c6 takes. That looks pretty dastardly, but I've got two knights. And the more knights on the board, the better it should be. So let's go here and cut the square. Let's go here. He's in really bad shape now. That doesn't really cause me any pain. I just take and move the king. It's just a harmless check. No one's afraid of checks. It's only a check. He is married to the game. Yeah. Why am I not playing Among Us with Levy right now? I play chess. I'm not an Among Us streamer. I play chess. I can play b5 here. I can go queen f5 or queen d7. I can also trade and go. If I trade and go b5, that looks quite good actually. Because takes, I check, and it's a good old fashioned right triangle. Thank you to Kuncospians for the 5 gifted subs. Thank you so much. Thank you to Talhudini for the gifted sub as well. Thank you so much, you guys. Appreciate it. Okay, but now I mean he's just losing the whole. He's like losing the whole chalupa here. I mean, he can go knight e3, but now this is like three pawns. I mean, it's just, this is pretty ugly. I think knight d5 is pretty clean. Oh, he's got queen c2, king g8. Wait, this is actually not trivial. It's still winning, but let's go here. Takes, I take, he takes, I take. Should just be winning. I had b5 knight e3 queen a2 rook d1 knight takes c4. No, because on knight takes on queen a2 he doesn't play rook d1, he goes queen takes g4, which is my original idea, you guys. So I take and now he just gets mated because I block. He rook f7, king g8, just ggs. Okay, you guys, it doesn't work and I'll tell you why. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, so I think it was right here. Yeah, no, it wasn't here. It was which position was it? Was it right here? Was it here? Queen a2. Wait, was it here? Wait. I don't know. Whatever. It doesn't quite work. But whatever. Let's keep going. I'm high on caffeine today. I'm not high on anything, you guys. Let's keep going. Let's keep playing this like open Sicilian. Let's keep going knight f3. Let's play d4 here. Let's just take. I'm high on life. Yes, I'm very high on life. I think I go here and bishop e3. I'm not worried about this pawn grab. I think it's very dangerous to go pawn grabbing here for black. So I also have knight a4. I think this is quite bad for white, for black. If he tries to grab, he can, but he's not going to. Unfortunately, he's smart. Let's go here maybe. Knight c6, interesting. Okay, I can play g4. I can also trade. I can also go a3, but then he takes and goes e5, so I'll just play knight b3, keep it really low-key chill. b5. Okay, strange. Now I go a3 because the pawn should be on b5 here. Let's go rook d1. I could have gone queen h3 too. I don't know why I didn't. I'm definitely playing for e5, f5, both diagonals here. Everything should be good. I don't think that's a good move because I think f5 and bishop h6 is very strong now, and he has a big problem that he can't release the pawn on e6 or the knight goes to d5. What happened to my 3400 rating? Well, this is blitz, not bullet chess, so it's different. Thank you to Insu for the 2 gifted subs. Thank you so much to Insu. Great energy. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good actually. It's probably because I went to the gym this morning and I haven't actually had any food, so I'm just feeling like kind of high on energy or high on something. I don't know. Let's take knight e5. I assume I throw in the juicer move first. I have bishop h6. Now Mikhail Tao would play rook f5 and bishop h6. Daniel might even do it, but I don't think it's actually enough. So I have f6 here. I have bishop e4. I know I'm much better. I just have to play as precisely. Let's go here. I threaten to take and then fossilize the bishop if he takes. I know this is really good for me. I just have to find the right f6 work here. Takes bishop d5. F6 looks playable, but it's not the right move. Maybe just bishop d4. Maybe knight d4. I mean, everything something has to be really good for me here. Knight e7 is a move. I think I'm just gonna go bishop d4 and try to keep it really simple here. Open up the lines. Like, I have like the double op, so I'm attacking on all lines here, kind of. I mean, this looks really dangerous. I don't know if it's actually good, but it looks really dangerous. It goes rook b8. I kind of expect that. I can play c3 to buff the bishop on d4. I can also just trade. I would really like to rotate my other horse though, so let's go knight d2. Knight c5. Maybe I just, yeah, I mean, this looks so bad. Does it just take? I'm gonna go knight f3 next move, and then I line this up too. I also have f6. Okay, let's go here. Takes, I take. I mean, this looks really, really dangerous. Black maybe is okay somehow, but in a blitz game I would think this is very unpleasant to play as a human, because I mean, he's got all kinds of issues in the center of the board. No one really cares about this weird queen side because our kings are over here and the monarch is the only thing that matters in the game of chess. I mean, this looks so bad, but king g7 is a good move. Okay, somehow there is no way to win, so let's just play b3 and consolidate. He's gonna have to go bishop f6 and hope that he can hold. Maybe he can. I don't know, we'll see. Just that, I don't really believe that's a good, oh wait, but he can take. No, then queen takes. I should have played queen d3. Okay, now I do get queen d3, however, and now he's in real trouble because I'm threatening to take and he can't take with a pawn. How is Jim Hikaru not concerned with DMCA? I'm not concerned about it because I've read the legal wording differently. That's why I'm not concerned about it, you guys. I've read it differently. Let's just take and go check. If he blocks, I just take. My understanding of it is different. That's why. Okay, let's just take and go here. I'm not worried. Let's go here. I hit the pawn. I have queen c7. If d5, I just take. Tell that to the court. Yeah, you guys don't understand what I'm saying, though. Okay, that's a good move, but now I think like I can go here and go here. This looks really bad for black. Go rook f3. He's got rook g8, but then I can go. Now he's in real trouble. Now he's in real trouble because like the whole king side is on fire for black. Because now this is a threat. Isn't it just GG? Classic right triangle. As always, chess is nothing but triangles. Let's go here. Nobody cares. Now I run this one up the board. I think h4 just ends the game. And check. And there you guys go. There's your checkmate. Pretty routine, pretty good stuff. Back to 3200, pretty good, can't complain. 7-0. I am going to take a short break, and I'm going to run to the restroom, you guys, so I will be right back in a couple of minutes. All right, you guys, let's keep going. Yeah, let's go again. So he takes. I think bishop b6 is just fine again. You can play bishop e6 here. I guess I primo this in case he takes. Oh, I had bishop takes f2 there, maybe. I don't know if that was a move. I think that was actually a move. Whatever. Let's just go bishop g4. Let's go knight h5. Knight f4 is coming. He has knight c4, but I'm not worried. Let's go knight f4. He has to take and then takes, maybe, but I think I'm doing very well again. b5, just knight a5. If takes, I just take. I'm muted. I'm not muted. No, I'm not muted. Very funny. Chat, stop being weird. I'm not muted. Stop being weird. You guys are trolling. Unfortunately, I've had it happen enough now that I know better. Let's go here. Oh, and now I just blundered knight g5. Shh. No, I have queen f5 maybe. Not cool. Not cool. Not cool, you guys. Not cool. I'm trying to get an adoption. You guys are like trolling me. I'm threatening to maybe take and hit this juicer because the bishop guards on the triangle, or on the diamond rather. I guess I pre-move. Wait, no, I don't have to, because if he takes on b6, I have bishop f5 maybe. I don't really know what's going on. By the way, I noticed there was a challenge from Mr. Benjamin Bach. Benjamin, why is your rating 2895? That's way too low. Get your rating up, dude. Thank you to Aguayer for the 18 months. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, so he still doesn't take, which is I find interesting, actually. Do I play h6 and then bishop e6? I guess I do, probably. Let's go here. Am I pushing for 3550 and bullet before the SEC? I would love to try to. Now I wonder, I think that's a mistake. I think I actually keep the two bishops because now I have an op on the long diagonal towards the king. I can play g5, g4, I can play b5. This all looks very, very happy times for me. Let's go 97, 95 maybe. And I think I'm doing well. Thank you, World of Moz, for the 3 months. Appreciate it, dude. I allowed that was a mistake. That was a mistake. But does it actually matter objectively? Because I can still reroute. It might matter. I can also, no, knight c8, knight a5. So knight a5 does cause me some problems. It does. It causes me actually real problems. I should not have allowed this. I'm going to have to take and go here and just consolidate and probably make a draw. Unfortunate, but it's okay. If e6 f6, maybe I take. I don't actually. Probably I go f6 knight d4. Let's go here. Maybe I should play c6 at some point to consolidate with knight d5. Yeah, I actually should do this so I have knight d5 at some point. Maybe g5. Still very much a game. Thank you, Cheese Tonks, for the 2 months. I think that's a bad move. I'm gonna go here, hit the juicer. Wait a second. There should be. Maybe just here, hit the pawn. Yeah, but see, now he misplayed this. I can go here, knight b6. Or just knight e6. Oh, I know I'm better. I just have to play this precisely. I just go. I have rook a8, maybe. And rook a2. He just goes rook b2, probably, though. And now I have to go here, b6, consolidate the bishop on the square. That's a free juicer, isn't it? It's free juicers. This is juicers are us. Guess I go here, c5, bishop c7. Now I have here, I have bishop a5. Just here, knight d4? What's he doing? What is my dude doing? I think he's trying to lose. Let's go check. I've got check and bishop c3. Whoa, this is getting very spicy. Wait, no, pawn's hanging. Wait a second. Let's go check. Why not? Ugh, I misplayed this. Let me go here. Ah, I just so misplayed this. He's got. Wait, so now I go. Do I have a bishop move? Whatever, I just got. I gotta flag him. So I can still go bishop c3. His king can't access anything. What's that? What is that? Okay, whatever, just move. Gotta move. Oh yes, come on baby, and I push h2 h1 and we win the game. There we go. Craigasm. No, it's only 8. You only craigasm at 10. Let's take and go here. Heavy e5 threats here. He does b4, which I think is a mistake. e5 is a big problem here. Wow. He's got knight e4, knight f. Wait, what? I'm threatening checkmate if he moves the juicer. Or this. He has this, but then I take here, and I should be winning, I think. I can take. Wait a sec. Takes knight e3 now. So takes. Maybe it's not winning, actually. I thought it was winning. It's not winning, but. It's not quite winning. Whoa! I thought queen b6 was completely fine. Why did he do this? He does it the other order. Okay, so I guess I just go rook e1. I consolidate the structure. If f5, I can always just take. Maybe this is wrong though. Maybe this is just wrong. Okay, I have to restart this then. Queen h4, rook h6, now takes. I misplayed this. Okay. Just go here. I guess I have rook h3 at some point. Don't really want to. King h1, he's got queen d8. How do I do this exactly? So I'm gonna go Knight H3, Knight G5, maybe. Try to attack here on the king side. With like H4, H5, maybe. It's not a great position to play, but I think it's okay. Thank you to Uncle's Peanuts for the prime. Thank you so much, Uncle's Peanuts. Thank you to Glenn Walk for the prime. Somewhat Mighty, thank you so much. Appreciate it. It's Queen D8. I'm gonna go Queen H6. I wanna go Knight G5 at some point. It's got D4, but then I just drop back. I mean, really what I wanna play is like some Knight G5. King H1. Whatever, let's just go Knight F2 and trade Rook H3 maybe. He's gonna go Queen G7. If Rook F7, I actually want to play H4 and just attack. I don't know if it's good, but it looks reasonable. Like Rook H3 maybe. Come back, let's go Knight G5. Now if he takes, I get the pawn and I get the lane. Does this really concern me? I don't think it does. I think he's actually playing this quite in a very actually insane kind of way. I think he's playing this in a completely insane way, because I'm getting a big attack on the king side here. My rook holds the glue. I mean, okay, he thinks he's taking a pawn on a2. Like, I really don't care one bit about that pawn. I don't move the bishop. Wait a second, how do I do this? I know I should have something. I don't want to take. Not bishop b2, not king f2, not bishop f2. Then knight e4, right? That's why bishop f1 is no good. So let's just go b3. So here it takes rook h3, I guess. I guess I still should pre-move this? Yeah, it's still a good move. I feel like I'm getting somewhere somehow. I'm gonna go rook h3 next move. Then maybe takes. Very dangerous position here for both sides. Wait. No, I take. Knight h7, rook g3, knight f6. And I'm the greatest genius of all time. Queen f6, rook no, he's got rook g4 maybe though. No, it's not so clear. Knight h7, rook g3. Knight f6 takes. Oh, whoa, dude! Dude, you're getting checkmated, surely. Wait. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm drunk or something. I know I'm not, but I feel a little bit drunk. Wait, I don't know what's wrong with me today. Sorry, you guys. Bear with me. It's gonna be a strange day. But now you just lose, bro. 98. GG's, my man. Okay, he's trying somehow to survive this. He's not going to, but I'm gonna be really mean and just play rook g3. Just take. Okay, let's go again. Let's go for one more. Sorry, you guys. Sorry, I don't know what's wrong with me today. I feel like I'm drunk or something. I really feel weird. Let's go here. I think it's bishop f5 and bishop b6. G5. I can just go bishop g6, for example. I can also just. I think I go here. Wait, what? Wait. Wait a second. If I take, he just wants to rook f1. Okay, whatever. Let's just go queen e7. Maybe I think I might actually just castle queenside in this game. Just go like h6 and f5 and just plow ahead on the king side maybe. Takes and queen g6 was enough to just draw probably, or even takes was fine. There's a4. Now I'm really tempted to actually. I'm really tempted to castle queenside here. I don't know why, but I'm feeling the happy times if I castle. Don't know if it's good. Is it good or not? Bishop g5, queen d7. Okay, let's see. If I go f5 to kick the knight, bishop g5, queen d7, knight moves. Let's just do it. I don't know if it's good. When he has bishop g5, queen d7, knight c5, I take, take with knight a5 or bishop f7. I don't know why this isn't just good for me, but we'll see. Yeah, but queenside castles is what I want to do, but I think it's probably not working when he moves the queen. I was not expecting that, actually. I really was not expecting that. Now, wait, but now he has no bishop a3 because his knight's on the wrong side of the board. Is e4, knight e5 a move here? Let's see. I can also play h6. Just go a6. I don't know if it's good. Because the bishop can't move, so he loses the knight. So all the ideas revolve around like trying to attack this diagonal. But if I don't let him attack this diagonal, it's a weird move. I just go... Ah, he's got bishop g5. Okay, there is an idea. Okay, that makes sense. Let's go here, knight d8 maybe. I feel like queen d7 was wrong, though. I should have just gone h6 and knight d8. Knight d8 maybe. Oh, I have e4, knight e5 too. Well, let's just go e4, knight d8, I guess. It was very, very sharp here. I don't know what's going on in this game. I think e4 was a bad move, though. It feels wrong. Intuitively, it feels like the wrong move somehow. I think it was wrong. Knight f4, however, kind of makes me a little happy, because maybe I can just play the game. Or I can just lose too. Somehow I've got a castle, but I can't. Yeah, I misplayed this very badly. Let's go here. Okay. Knight of seven. This is not good, but I think I'm okay. Not okay, but within range where I might not lose. Take and take. A5, I just drop back and castle, and then it's a game, I think, because I also have knight d6 and rook c8 too. Bishop f4, what is that? He wants an end game, so I guess I just take knight d6 maybe. Let's go here. If he takes, I take and just castle. I also have e3. I can probably draw this now. I don't think I can win, but I should be able to draw this, I think. Maybe just e3, maybe rook f8. Let's just go here. Maybe just c6. I can draw this. I'm not going to win the game, but a draw is okay, considering how lost I was. Or he can try to not win. This also is an idea. I don't know what he's doing here. Go here. Hit the bishop. Big, okay, goes there. They go here maybe. No, g5 too. G5, gf4, rook c8. Knight h4. Good g5. Oh, I've got no time. I just got to move. Okay, we both have no time. I have to cheese him on the clock. What was that? Oh, I missed it. I missed it. I was supposed to go king a8. I just flubbed it. Forgot about rook a6. It was so bad. Ugh. I just forgot about rook a6. If I go king a8, I would have flagged him. I forgot about rook a6. Forgot about rook a6 completely, or I would have won that game. No, the worst part is that it's minus 13 for a loss. But whatever, I'll just beat him three in a row and stop. Let's just castle. It's stupid. Okay, this is a line that I haven't played in many, many years. This, of course, is just losing. He has to go like bishop d6, bishop e3, and then I think it's bishop g4, h3 or something. I had a game in... I had this position in a game in Westfield, New Jersey. I believe it was 1997. I was the black pieces, and it was against this master, this FM, I think it was. Oris Popovich, I remember, was his name. And so I've had this. It's like Bishop G4, H3, Bishop D1, Queen G7 is like winning or something, I think. It's like this is some like ancient line. Okay, Bishop E6 is definitely not a good move. I just go G5. Queen F2, Knight F4. I know this is not good, but why is this not good? I just go here, maybe just Knight D5 even. Can also just take. No, takes is not good. Let's go Knight D5. He's got to take. I take, and then I think this is supposed to just be very good for White. Oh no, Bishop E. Oh no, wait, no, no, wait a second. Oh no, I think actually no. Wait, I think no. Bishop B5 is the move because Bishop B5 is the move. That's what it was. Yeah, Bishop B5 is the move that was winning. Okay, so Rook C8, I go C3, King B1, I can take, of course. Danke, thank you so much, man. Okay, so now I can obviously take, I can go Bishop H3, I can go Rook D1. This is supposed to be pretty bad for black. Let's play H4, H5. It probably goes like Queen A5, King B1, and then something. Imagine not seeing Bishop B5, yeah. No, I think I would have won that game if I hadn't blundered the mate in one. If I had gone King E8, I wouldn't have blundered it. But I was like, I was just too slow throughout the game. Thank you, Viscera, for the Prime. Appreciate it. Thank you, Viscera. Thank you to Baron for the 5 months. Exegod Nemesis for the 5. Dirty Vagu for the 3. Chess Tonks for the 2. World of Moz, Aguirre, and Sandor Sabo. Thank you so much, you guys. Of course, I just go H5. He's got E4, but I think just Queen G4 is fine. He probably plays B5 or something. I don't know what he does. Although I guess I can take and line this up. Okay, so let's see. So if I take, he takes, I take. Takes up Bishop H3. I think this is actually really bad for him. Takes. He can actually, oh, he can actually play HG there, can't he? Hmm. I can also take and move my queen up to G4. I can also just move my king over, I guess. Am I really worried about takes and Queen G2? I probably am. Yeah, whatever, let's just do it. That's a mistake. He had to take with the H pawn. Now I think he's in really bad shape. Bishop E6 is a huge problem. He's still okay, but he should just be significantly worse in this resulting endgame. Because the bishop is so powerful that even if he gets some king queenside play, I don't have to move the king, but I will. So he's still trying to go like Queen B6 or something, but I have Rook D3. I also have Queen E4. Queen E4, F3 could be a problem. Rook E1, B4, I just take. Let's go here. I want to go Queen E4 and trap the bishop, because then when he goes back, he gets mated. It's a classic, you know, Pyramid of Giza. Because the bishop holds g8. And I think I'm winning. Okay, queen e4, and what's his move? I don't understand. He can take, but I just take. He takes, I just take. And it's just GG's. Thank you, Marmaduke. Appreciate it. Thank you for 3 months, Marmaduke. Edge of GG. Okay. And now you resign, dude. Resigns. Let's go again. I'm going to drop the bishop back. Castles. Okay, now I think I castle. I think Bishop F5 is fine here. can go here because I have e4 next move. Thought you could not play songs on Twitch now. Oh, I could have taken and gone e4 maybe. Actually, those may be interesting. Anyway, let's just go a5, b5, knight e7. Bishop a3, bishop c5, pretty normal stuff. I have knight g6, of course. Now I can also just play e4 too. Let's see, do I want to play e4 first? I think I do. If bishop a3, I just go bishop c5, of course. If he takes, I just take. If he takes, I take. It's all pretty good here. Let's just take. It's got big problems on the diagonal. I have knight c5 next move. Should be pretty good for me. I also have knight f5, knight g3. My opponent has misplayed this quite severely. I should be much better now. Do other stuff on stream other than playing chess? I would like to, but I have competitive tournaments coming up soon, so I don't want to go too far off the ranch. Knight g5, wow. I have a tournament in mid-November or end of November, you guys. I have knight d2. Let's see, I can take and play h6. That's actually not what I want to do. Maybe take some knight g6. They can go here and queen g6, hit the bishop. Queen g3 is also a big threat. No chess is the best, yeah. I thought I had queen g6 and like knight h4. It's got bishop d5 in between. You can also just play h6 and kick the bishop. Wait, knight g3? Just go here, hit the bishop. Oh, and it's knight g3, bishop e7 though. Thank you for the 6 months, man. Appreciate it. Thanks. Misplayed this. Guess I'll just play here and trade some rooks. Put pressure on the juicer on f2. What? Check? GG's. Bamba. Ba ba bamba. This bishop d7, he's playing this weird like Kuprechik system that I studied in like the 1999. This bishop d7, bishop c6, it's playable. It's named after Viktor Kuprechik, the grandmaster. It's okay, but you tend to run into trouble, so it's not great. Yeah, I thought it was the greatest system in the world, and then I played against the American grandmaster Alexander Shabalov and like in just some random tournament at the Marshall Chess Club, and he just kicked my ass. And then I was like, this line is just totally like garbage. Let's go g5. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's like he just did some normal like rouser setup stuff, and I just basically just lost, and I was like, okay, this is just garbage. Let's go here and here. I love it when you explain your memory of tricks. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I just played it, and he just did some normal setup, and he just rolled, man. I was just like, what's the point of... You play this fancy bishop d7, bishop c6, and you feel like, ooh, it's such a fancy line, and then you just basically lose, and you're just like, what did I do? Like, what was the point? Like, why am I playing like this? No, I think I was 12 years old, but yeah, it was just like, I did that, and I'm like, why am I doing this? It's just absolute garbage. Knight d5 and rook d5. I can play bishop h3. I think actually I should just launch maybe. Yeah, there's no trick, right? Takes, I just take. So I can just slow, I can just play for the quick, I can play for the slow grind. I do have knight d5 at some moment as well, depending. I can also retreat maybe and line up some fossils towards the bishop. B5 is a strange move. I don't think it's a good move, because first of all, I can take. Secondly, I can play bishop h3. Third, I can play knight d5. Fourth, I can probably do something else. Wait, if I just take, what's the point? He's down a pawn. It's not a b5 is hanging too at the end, actually. Queen c7. Yeah, because b5 is hanging here at the end, it's okay. Once he goes queen c7 and we trade, so it's all good. So he has to go back. If this pawn wasn't on b5, it'd be okay, but because he has to go here, we trade and I win this pawn, it's game over, basically, at least from a technical standpoint. It doesn't mean I'll convert because I'm not very good, but maybe. I never see you play d4 openings as a trash. D4 is completely fine. I thought I had h6 here. h6, bishop f6, queen h2, bishop. Oh, that's annoying. She takes c3, queen c6. She's 7, bishop c7. 1 second, dude. I think I'm going to go for the hero move here. Takes. Oh, but he's got bishop e4, huh? Okay, let's see. h6, bishop f6, let's see, queen c5, bishop c3, queen c6, bishop e5. I mean, it's two pawns. b8, I mean, this has to be winning. Go here. He has to take. I really wanted to take and go here and mate him, but unfortunately he has this, which holds everything, and then it's like a wooden shield. Do I take first or do I take first? I'm guessing I take first. Because on rook c8, I go queen b5. Oh, I think he's got queen c7 or something. Hmm. Oh, this might be tricky. I thought this was clean, but this is not clean. I have to go rook d7, queen f4, and then maybe I go queen f5, and then like I line up something with takes and mate. He has queen e3, and then I go like here. This is very weird. Let's go here. He has to go here, only move. Then I go here, and then he goes here for the potential ice skater, but then I go here, but then I go there and that. Is this okay? Oh, I missed this move, shoot. But I have queen d3. Yes, I have this. Oh, but he's got queen b8 back, and then b3 should be winning, but it's a little bit messy. Queen b8, queen b5, queen g3, bishop c4, rook b8, rook b7, and I just win the game, and I'm so bad at chess. Why did I allow this? He goes queen f4, which actually is not a good move, because now I just take and I go e5. No? What am I missing? I don't understand. It's just checkmate, no? You can will just work e8, I guess. If I take and go g6, just take. Okay, now I just need to convert this. Let's just trade queens. What am I doing here? That's just GG. Rook d8, game over. Let's be fancy schmancy with the patented ice skater here. When he takes the queen, I go check, and the king cannot come up because my bishop holds and the pawn holds the other square, and he would have to block, and then it's the classic ice skater. So we win the game 12-1. It's okay, it's not great, but it'll have to do. I mean, 10-0 would have been better, but can't get everything you want in life.